Okay, so now we have that modal finished and it's looking good. It stores the email just fine. It does the AJAX and all that. But there's an error that came up because of a spelling error and also just little bugs that we want to fix in this one. So the first thing is you might notice it says log out over here. Well, this is popping up in log out. It shouldn't be. So if we take a look at our code, authenticated is spelled incorrectly. So authenticated, once we fix that, and I refresh in here, it shouldn't pop up. So after a few seconds, we're not likely going to see it now, which is good. The other side of it, if I do log out and I see this, notice it just came up, but if I refresh in here, it's going to come up in a few seconds. I don't actually want this to show up on login or register or anything that has accounts in the URL. It shouldn't show up. So what I'm going to do now is add another clause to this if statement and go if and not accounts in request.get full path. So if I refresh in here now, after a few seconds, it's definitely not going to pop up, where on the other pages it will. And again, after it takes a few seconds, of course, for it to actually pop up. And there it is. Okay, so now that we've got that, that's good. That's what we want to see. And we also have it where, you know, if they dismiss it, it doesn't necessarily bug them right away. It'll bug them after a certain amount of time. So that's going to be something that you might want to check out. Another thing that you also might consider doing is adding the same functionality that we did with the closing that out. We might want to add that functionality in with the modal itself. Or we just keep it as a nag and maybe we just change the time period as to when it'll ask them and what page and stuff like that. That's really up to you. Okay, so now what we need to do is get started with the actual checkout process. So if I get a product, add it to the cart, go to checkout. Of course, I need to log in. And let's go back into checkout. I need to do something here. So the first thing I'm going to want to do is add the shipping address, and then the billing address, and then the credit card, and then boom, that should complete our order. Because we're not going to need a whole lot more than that. Now, of course, if you have gift cards and stuff like that, those are things that might have to be added later. But for now, all we're going to do is those three things. So to do that, we have to create a new model for our addresses, and we're going to put that model inside of accounts. So in here, I'm just going to go to class, call it user address models.model, and it's going to be user, it'll be models.foreignkey, and it's settings.auth user model, and then we will do a street address, or actually just do address, because we don't need street address. Address will be what it is. So models char field, and we'll do max length of 120, and then address 2. So if there's a second line, models.char field, max length of 120, null equals to true, and blank equals to true. I don't think that it's very often that there's a third line, but if you are international and you really want to make sure that there is one, you could add that third line in here. I'm not going to do it. Just going to show you that you can do it and you should if you need it. And then we'll do city and then state. So for the US, state works. In other countries, it might be Providence or you might not even have state, which is fine. And then country, possibly, again, depending on where you're going. So if it's an international thing, then you'll want country as well. You can just copy this one right here. All right, and now you're going to want zip code or postal code. I'm going to go off with the convention for the US and do zip code, and I'll do models. I'm going to leave it as char field because, again, if you want it to be international, sometimes it's not integer. So the other option would be an integer field here, and I'm going to leave it the max length being 25, and I don't actually want that to be empty. And matter of fact, I don't want null and blank to be, the country to be empty. State, I will leave empty. City, I will not leave empty. Address 2, I will leave empty. Okay, so we've got pretty much all their shipping information that we need. We might want their phone number. So we'll do another char field for that. and I'm just going to do 120 here. Okay. So that's their address. Then we would want a couple Boolean values being like shipping. So shipping address, or we could say is shipping, but we can just leave it as shipping address. So models.boolean field default, I'm going to say it's true. And then we also want billing. So if this is their billing address, models.boolean field default equals to false. And then we probably want a timestamp and all that. So I'm going to scroll down and go ahead and grab these timestamps here. Scroll back up, paste this in. Okay, so now we've got our model. We just need to have a Unicode. So define the Unicode of self and return the string of self.user.username. Okay, so notice my user model is required. Now, if you're wanting to have guests accounts and guest checkout, then you could use it where your user account is not required. But how we have it all set up right now, if we look at our checkout view, we have our login required there. So checkout view, of course, being in orders. We have the login required actually being there. So if you didn't have this login required, then it's okay. You wouldn't actually need to show the login required like this. You would just have them check out without a user model. But since we want it to be registered to a registered user, or they're, when they make purchases, we want them to be a registered user, then we're going to go ahead and do this. And that's okay now. I mean, I think a lot of services have still add guest checkout, and in some cases it might make sense. But for us, if you're making a full-on e-commerce site and you're planning on selling to these people multiple times, then I would say having them sign up is fairly painless and pretty much what something that most people expect, I think, at this point. Where a long time ago, they probably would have said, oh no, we want to have a guest account where they can just put their email address or something. And then again, that also might make more sense on a digital service. So if you're buying something digital, perhaps you won't even need their address, of course, but you also might only need their email address. You don't need them to make an account or anything like that. Okay, so cool. So now we've got this. Let's go ahead and add it into our database. Do Python manage.py schema migration accounts --auto, and then Python manage.py migrate. There we go. And let's add this into our admin. So inside of admin, I'm just going to, of course, accounts admin. I'm going to import user address, and then I'm going to make a user address admin, because I will most likely update some things. So class meta, model equals to user address, and then admin.site.register, user address and user address admin. Great, so now we've got that. Let's go ahead and run the server again. Let's check this out. And go log in as my super user. And we've got user address here. Great, so now I can actually add in some address stuff. Notice the address, city, country, zip code, phone, all that stuff is required. Great, so now that we have this, I'm actually gonna show you something new. It's an app called Local Flavor. Now this app allows us to get data, or actually even have fields or model fields or form fields as the default. So if we click on the United States, which is where I'm from and that's what I'm using, but as you see, it supports all types of countries and you can use this. You have these different fields that we can actually work with. I'm not going to really go through them specifically, but we also, like the forms fields would be used in a form, and then the models would be model fields. So I'll just give you a quick example. If I imported this from models and went into our models.py, oh, well, actually, first off, what we'd have to do is pip install django-localflavor. And I actually already have it installed, but it's there. And then we'd go into our settings.py, and we would add local flavor here. And then we'd sync the database. All right, so local flavor is installed, so now I can use it. I'm going to go ahead and run the server again. But in my models, I could go below this. So I'd go from local flavor models, import, and then whatever field I was trying to use. So let's say, for instance, it was phone number field. I could do that and use this in lieu of the phone models that we had here, which would be this. And then you wouldn't have to have max length. You could just do that. And that would actually take over that, and it would have its own validations and stuff like that for it. I'm going to not use that because, well, frankly, this shopping cart or this e-commerce service in general is going to service, well, maybe anywhere in the world. So why limit ourselves? But there is another one that we have, and that's this data here. And if we had this data, so let's say, for instance, I wanted to just have the United States states, so all the states and the District of Columbia, I could import them here. So I'm going to copy this first part and go ahead and go from that, import, let's say US states. And then now for states, I could do choices equals to US states. Well, if we have that, we might as well have provinces, right? Like Canada. If we really wanted to get this thing working for all around, you know, all around the country or all around the world, we might even get even smarter than that, have every type of city and stuff like that. But let's not get too far ahead of ourselves. I'm just going to go ahead and use the U.S. states. Realistically, the person who puts this in, a lot of their information will be validated. We can actually validate it through another means, which is something we'll do down the line. But for now, we have our choices being U.S. states, so we can actually see what that's like. Go into Chrome, go ahead and look at our admin. If I refresh in here, notice that this now has states actually listed into it. So California, where I am, would work. And then let's just say one Main Street, city, Newport, and country, USA, 92660, and 555555, like that. Save and continue. There we go. So we have this now as an address that in theory works. And the choices itself could change as well. You could have, let's say for instance, we wanted to have a few other ones, so new states. So let's just, for some reason, we would have more than what we've got here. We'd create a new tuple here, and we would just say what we're going to store in the database. So let's say A, B, and then this is A, B, C state, right? So this is the what's actually stored in the database, and this is what's going to be seen by the user. Copy that and paste it one below, and then we'll say B, C, and then we'll just call it a B, C state. And then now we could do new state plus equals to US states and change our choices to new state. And we go back in here, do a nice little refresh, and we see that AB state is now in there, and so is BC state. So it gives us a nice list of states, and it also allows us to update and add these states as we would like. So of course, these aren't real states, so I'm just going to leave them out here, and I'm going to comment this whole thing out and just put new state being US states. And there we go. So we've got our US states here showing up. Now it's just time to actually have a form for this user address and put it into our view for our addresses. So the first thing would be right here. So let's go ahead and do that. We're going to go into forms and we want to import this model. So we're going to go from dot models import user address. And then I'll put it at the very top, and I'll call it class user address form. And it's going to be forms.modelForm, class meta, form equals to user address, fields equals to. So we want a list of all the fields we're going to use. So I'm just going to copy this whole thing. Well, with the exception of timestamp, just copy this whole thing and paste it in here. And just delete what we want and what we don't want. So user, we definitely don't want. Address, we do. Address 2, we do. City, state, country, zip code. Now the reason I do it this way is just so I don't miss anything right? Because if you accidentally miss something, then well, you might not want it to be missed, right? So what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to get rid of shipping, because by default, we're going to have it as the default shipping, because that's the first field that they're going to be entering. And then now we can just go ahead and put this into a list. And city, better yet, let's do it this way. Comma, state, comma, just put these in quotes. Actually, I think if you select it and hit shift quote, it will do it for you. Just add some commas at the end here. And we can tab this in. So now we have our list of fields that's actually going to be shown up for our form. You could also do what's called exclude and just have a list of fields that you want to exclude. But I'd recommend not doing this because the fields, it would be better to write them explicitly. So then if you're later wanting to make changes to something, your fields will automatically be this versus exclude. It's not going to tell you a whole lot about the form. Okay, so now we've got this. Let's go into our checkout form, our checkout view, that is. And we want to import the accounts forms. So from accounts.models, import user address form. And then, oh, that's actually forms. And then we also are going to do from accounts.models, import user address, because at some point we might want to do that. Okay, so now that we've got this, let's go back down to our checkout. And we will now have a new field here, called it address form equals to user address form. And it's going to be request, post, or none. If address form dot is valid, we'll say new address equals to the instance that we're going to be getting. So it's going to be address form.save commit equals to false. And then we want to add new address.user equals to request.user and then new address.save. All right. So now that we've got this, we can go ahead and take a look at this in our view itself. So in our context, we need to add this in. So address form is address form. Cool. So now we can see that. Let's go ahead and look at it into, let's open up home.html. Or actually, we need to change this to, let's do orders slash checkout.html because it's not home anymore. So we need to actually create that template. Scroll down, orders, new file here, save it as checkout.html. And extends base.html and then block content. Then we'll do address form as p, as paragraph in block. And let's turn it into a form with the method of post action being what it is here. And CSRF token. And let's end the form off, put a submit button, input submit or input type equals to submit, class equals to BTN, BTN default, and we'll do value of save or add address. All right, so now that we've got that, let's go ahead and look at our checkout, actually. Oh, no user models. So I've got a view order here, line 10 in our views. Scroll all the way to the top. So this should be account.models. All right. So now there's that. Need to add some products into our cart here. Add to cart, check out. Model form has no model class specified. That's not good. So let's go ahead and look at our model form. Oh, it says form equals user address when it should say model equals user address. Do a refresh in here. And there we go. So now we see our form. And we can say, we see that it says billing, which is useful for us. So this is how you can actually add your addresses and stuff like that. But maybe we don't want it to be in the same view as the checkout, right? We might want to have it in a separate view of its own. So then if they don't have an address, it's going to do that. And then after they add the address, it'll go back to the checkout. That's one way to do it. Or we could have it where there's multiple steps for the checkout too, where the first step would be adding their address. The second step would be adding a billing address if possible. Or we could also do it where we use Ajax. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to have an address form here. We're going to have an address for billing form. And if they select billing, it will keep it just as the one. If they deselect, or if billing is deselected, which is how it's going to start, it's going to have another field just like this, or another form just like this. And then if they select it, then that one's going to go away. And then they're going to add it and save it and do all that stuff. And then once the address is added and we have it all in there, then all they'll have to do is add their credit card and do all that. And they'll do it all on one page so we don't have to reload a bunch of stuff. But all of that information is still going to be taken from using a actual different views and all that stuff and using these forms as we see here. It's going to be very similar to like what we've already done with some of our Ajax, but it's going to take a couple steps to do that. So now that we're at this point, let's go ahead and stop now and we will pick it up in the next one.